Thanks, Grant. Appreciate it.
Oh, no problem. So, what did you think, one, when you heard about this kid with a, chews his Pop-Tart into a gun, gets suspended? And then, you know, if you were like me, you probably saw all these stories. There's dozens of them like this.
I would have to say the worst part of it is I was not surprised. Just the way our society has gone, you know, say the last 20 years, anti-gun. The worst comment is I was like, yeah, I guess that's the kind of thing you expect these days. Not that it's right, obviously, but that kind of stuff is occurring more and more every day.
No, and I will tell you, I lived in Florida for a while. You know, they have, I know they always look at it as a swing state, but there's some good conservative folks in Florida. Most Floridians love their guns. Even Democrat Floridians love their guns. And the fact of the matter is, Florida has big issues at hand, just like Texas, just like California. They got to waste time passing a bill like this. Now, I'm glad they passed the bill, but what a waste of time because people don't have any common sense.
Yes, they basically passed a bill that said kids are allowed to play and be kids. Now in Florida, kids who point their finger and go pow pow or bring little fake guns, you know, to school are now allowed to play, whereas I guess before the bill they were not.
So the gentleman who wrote this bill was State Senator Greg Evers. He sponsored the legislation. And so he was asked about if anything like this had ever happened in his district because the Pop-Tart situation happened in Maryland. And he said, yeah, two kids were sitting down reading a book, and there was a picture of a Wild Wild West show, and one person has a gun. One student tells another student that he's got a cap gun at home that's the same as the one in the picture. Kirk, can you guess what the teacher does?
I think I can guess now. I haven't heard that story, but I think I know where this is going.
Yeah, the teacher sends him to the principal's office and expels him.
Jeez.
Yeah, crazy, right?
Yeah, zero tolerance has gone way too far.
Has gone way too far. So here's my thing. You're with Texas Law Shield. You protect gun owners. Anything happens. My fear is that we have this such a hypersensitivity towards guns now that a gun owner is going to get himself in some trouble. And, you know, they're just going to haul him into court for even brandishing a weapon if he doesn't have a license. Who knows?
No, that situation we see all the time in Texas and around the country. It just depends on where the was the district attorney educated in the People's Republic of California? Was the officer, did he grow up in New York? It just depends on personal biases a lot of the time, regardless of what the law is.
So not just kids, but you've got to, if you're an adult and you've got a gun, you've got to look out for it, don't you?
That is correct.
Kirk Evans, I appreciate you coming on the program. Thank you so much.
I appreciate it. Thank you.